Hey guys, this is a video that many of you have been requesting. Today, we're going to compare the Sennheiser MT-W3 to the Sony WF-1000XM4, and we're going to deep dive into how they stack up in these areas: their call quality, sound, and noise cancelling performance. By the way guys, I will be making more videos covering the MT-W3, so if you don't want to miss out on future content from this channel, get subscribed and tap the bell button to stay notified. I've also split this video into chapters, so if you want to, you can simply skip to the parts you're interested in. Right now, we're gonna jump straight into comparing their call quality in both quiet and noisy environments, using some really loud cafe-style background noise and some wind noise coming from this fan over here. I am now making a phone call in a quiet place using the Sennheiser MT-W3. Background noise. I'm now making a phone call in a noisy place using the Sennheiser MT-W3. I'm now making a phone call in a quiet place using the Sony WF-1000XM4. Background noise. I'm now making a phone call in a noisy place using the Sony WF-1000XM4. So, overall, I think the MT-W3s did perform better than the Sony's in terms of call quality. In quiet conditions, my voice did sound more natural on the Sony's, yes, but under extremely noisy conditions, when it's really being tested, the MT-W3s are doing a better job at reducing background noise. Now we're going to compare their active noise cancelling using the same background noise as before. So they both are quite comparable. They did about as well at cancelling low frequency rumble, but the Sony's do seem to perform a bit better at muffling mid-range noises. It probably is the foam tips, but overall both the Sennheisers and the Sony's are quite close in terms of active noise cancelling. In terms of transparency mode, the Sennheisers do feel quite transparent, but you still get a bit of hiss in the background, so it does sound more like pass-through audio. In contrast, the Sony's sound a little more clean, more transparent, almost like you're not wearing earbuds at all. That being said, the Sennheisers are not far behind at all in this aspect. But how exactly do they compare in terms of sound quality? After repeated A to B comparisons, I can safely say that the MT-W3s sound more relaxed and a bit more laid back in the mid-range. So if you're listening to anything with vocals, it sounds like the Sony's have a bit more attack and vibrance in the vocals. Vocal separation on the Sony's also seem to be cleaner. That's because the MT-W3s seem to have a bit of upper bass bloat that bleeds into the mids. However, the Sennheisers do seem to place more emphasis on background detail and sound staging. So while the Sony's sound just about as open, there is more airiness on the M3s, with background details shining just a bit brighter. This frequency sweep shows that the MT-W3 have more emphasis on the upper mids and highs. That's probably the reason, in terms of bass, The MTW3s present a heavier thump. So if you like more muscle, more impact in your bass, it's got that. But the Sonys seem to emphasize on bass being more clean. It doesn't have as much thump as the Sennheisers, but it does have more texture. Now let's see if the Sennheisers have any lip sync delay when watching videos on both iOS and Android devices. We're gonna test that using the iPhone SE 2020 and the Samsung Galaxy S22 Plus.
Hey guys, it hasn't even been a month since the Sony WH-XM5s were launched, and now we've got a new firmware update for it. It's update number 1.1.1, and Sony's update notes aren't very specific. Hey guys, it hasn't even been a month since the Sony WH-XM5s were launched, and now we've got a new firmware update for it. It's update number 1.1.1, and Sony's update notes aren't very specific.
So, looking fantastic there, no noticeable lag, but that's also partly because video apps like YouTube have their own latency correction which minimizes that lag. But when speaking of mobile games, they don't have that automatic latency correction. So let's see how the MTW3s compare to the XM4 earbuds in terms of lip sync delay when playing mobile games. This is the earbuds latency in milliseconds after deducting the phone's hardware lag. So they are very similar to the Mark 4s, as in, if you game with the MTW3s, you may still get a bit of lag when playing FPS games on mobile. Its syncing is a bit tighter on Android compared to the XM4 earbuds, but the difference is so small that it's not really possible to tell the difference without slow motion. To conclude, it seems that Sennheiser has caught up with the Sony Mark IVs. Its call quality is better, and it does support aptX adaptive codec, somewhat comparable to Sony's LDAC, although it's debatable whether most people can even tell the difference compared to aptX HD. In terms of features, it used to be that the Sonys were way ahead, because Sony's Headphones Connect app was more feature-rich, had more custom options. But now the Sennheisers are coming very close after their big revamp of the Smart Control app. There's now transparency adjustment, its custom sound settings are almost as good as the Sony's now, providing presets and a simple graphic EQ. It even offers something quite similar to Sony's adaptive sound control. They're calling it Sound Zones. You can make presets of transparency levels and EQ settings tagged to specific locations. So when the app sees that you're approaching that location, it triggers the preset. Not a feature I'll use personally, because I prefer to stick to just one setting, but perhaps others may find that useful. In terms of fit, I think the Sennheisers are easier to wear, and more comfortable too, because these use silicone ear tips. The Sonys use foam tips, so it requires a bit more adjustment and elbow grease to wear. Another benefit of silicone is durability. Foam tips have to be changed occasionally if you use them every day, because the foam does wear out eventually. That does not happen with silicone. Now, those are all compelling reasons why the Sennheisers make a great alternative. However, there are also reasons why the Sony's might be more appealing. It's got a smaller case, more portable, its noise cancelling is slightly better, and for people who just want to make sure that they are getting the most out of their high-res music, the Sony's are high-res certified, which means that these have double the usual frequency range, and that gives extra headroom for your music to shine. It also features DSEE Extreme, so when you're streaming audio, this upscales the audio by patching the missing bits of data that might have been lost during Bluetooth transmission, mostly in the upper frequencies. I use this feature every day, and I can say that the audio does sound cleaner and better separated with DSEE Extreme. So there are compelling reasons to pick either the Sony's or the Sennheisers. It really depends on what you think is important. If it's call quality and a more comfortable fit, the MTW3 should be your choice. If, however, you need your earbuds to be high-res certified and more portable, I would go for the Sony's. Everything else about them is comparable, but what do you guys think? The MTW3 or the Sony Mark IVs? Comment down below. Next, I will be comparing the MTW3s to other earbuds. So if you don't want to miss out on those videos, get subscribed and tap the bell button to stay notified. Thanks for watching, smash like and share if you like this video, it helps a lot. A big shout out to my Patreon supporters. As always, you can also join us on the world's most popular gaming chat app, Discord, if you want to hang out or chat. Link is in the box down below. Click here to watch my review of the Sennheiser CX Plus or watch another video from this channel.